Hi all, Jigs here. And today I'm going to cover the team building features of Project Plan 365. These features help you better collaborate with team members, project stakeholders, and even your boss. Now you may have missed this team building workflow when you first started your free 30-day trial, so I'm going to cover that, and I'll also show you how to build a team no matter where you are in your project plan. From the welcome screen, you can build your project team from the get-go. All you need are the email addresses of your new team. This screen lets you add additional team members besides yourself, and then also lets you add others, as many as you need. Here you iteratively add new members and select their role within the system. The role of editor is assigned to a team member who is expected to add, edit, or otherwise change tasks, resources, or dates within the plan. The role of read-only is assigned to team members who just need to view the plan, but are not expected to make any changes. These roles can be changed at any time, and I'll show you how to do that in a minute or two. Now let me quickly add all of my team members. Behind the scenes, the system is sending out emails to each new team member added, and these emails will help get everyone on board quickly. So in case you missed all of that during installation, no problem. You can access the team building screens by clicking on Manage Account from the upper right of the app. A browser window opens and prompts you to sign in. And once in, you can use the Project Plan 365 portal to review your account, manage team members, projects, and subscriptions. Here you can also change your password. To begin teamwork on a new project, go back to the app and add the first task. Note that your team is now listed in the Resource Names dropdown, making task assignment that much easier. It's important to note that projects are not available to the team until they are saved in the provided cloud drive, Drive 365. So let's do that now. Now that the project plan is saved to Drive 365, everyone in your team will see this project. Team members with the role of editor will be able to open these projects and edit them, while team members with the role of read-only cannot. You can always add a new team member on the fly using the drop-down list. The procedure here should be familiar now. We add new members just as before. There, now the new team member has been assigned to task number 1. When saving the plan, you are prompted to officially add the new resource to the team. This allows for local resources as well as team resources. Looking at our resource sheet, we now see our team and any other type of resources that we may have added. For any new project we start going forward, the team will always be here. So now that you have tasked and resourced a project, it's time to share with the team.
Just navigate to the Share ribbon and hit Share.
As you begin to type into the Add People by Email address field, all of your established team members are selectable. Add a message and tap Share, and all those listed will be notified by email. And here you can also create a link or a PDF file or an MPP file of the plan, whatever you need.
Here's a sample of the email sent when shared that explains what the team member can now do with the shared plan.
Well, that sums up team building with the Project Plan 365 using both the initial workflow and the management portal. We also covered adding team members on the fly and how to share projects to the team. See our other training videos to learn how to use real-time collaboration and other team-related features of Project Plan 365. Thanks for watching and happy planning.